Good morning,
hey.
Good morning, strangers. Happy December. We're back. I know y'all are used to me taking months long breaks, but we're back. I'm not gonna say I'm gonna be back for real this time. Look at these bumps.
Where your bumps come from?
Anyways, we're back, you guys. I'm going to be vlogging the whole month of December. I'm gonna try my best.
Are we doing that exclusive content too?
What exclusive content? What exclusive content?
That Garner's After Dark.
Let's do a theme song. We're back. Join in.
Squabble.
Anyways, you guys, excited to be vlogging again. I miss y'all. Every social media, get out of my butt. Every social media platform is different audience, and I just get different feelings and like vibes. I just get different vibes from like different platforms. I feel like YouTube is more like cozy. TikTok is like wild, like do whatever you want. Instagram is like a show me, show off what you got. So I love being on YouTube because everybody's so down to earth. But I'm looking forward to it. So I don't have a lot of stuff planned today, but we'll get the day started anyway. Okay, so you guys remember when I told you that we were moving and why we were moving and all that. So our move was temporary. I told you guys, whenever we moved last time, we moved temporarily because of everything that was going on. It's hot in here. But today we moved back into a bigger house with space, and I'm super happy about it. Y'all aren't gonna see us moving for a long time. I really wish I knew everybody like individually on each platform. Think it would be a lot easier to like share things, but I don't, so I won't. Let me go see what they're doing. Anyway, so I'm super happy but super tired. I feel like God has, we've rented like all the houses that we've gotten, and we've only ever moved into brand new houses, like never lived in new builds, first to live in there. And we've always been blessed, and I love that for us. I've been thinking about like renting versus like home owning, and of course there's so many like pros and cons to doing both. Home ownership is very important. Building, customizing our own home is our end goal. But the ease that comes with being able to rent and then renting something as nice as we do is definitely great. Just because if anything happens, like if there's anything going on as far as like just with the house, then you make a phone call and it's not on you. But then also, you know, sometimes that's annoying. We will be here for a minute until we're in a place to customize something. So we've been taking little notes of like things that we like and dislike about certain homes, appliances, all that. But this house is almost exactly like the other house that we had, the bigger one. I think that one was almost like 4,000 square foot. This one's about 3-ish. So I definitely have the space back, which I love and need, because to not be able to hear the kids when they upstairs playing, amazing. We got the media room back. We got the playroom back, which I love for the girls. We had downsized just because we knew it was going to be temporary. So we were in a townhouse, which it was fine. It's just not enough space. Like we have 4 girls running around. But I got my bathroom back. It's pretty much exactly the same. The shower, the garden tub. You see his little sink over there compared to mine. Mine is huge and I got a million drawers. But yeah, I'm super happy about it. So they're unloading.
So you're not doing any directing?
No, I'm vlogging.
You said you were directing.
Okay, I will. I'm waiting on the donuts.
There's a chair in the middle of the shit where you can sit in all your queendom and direct.
See how he just like to. That's why I'm blurred. That's why you blurred out. You
women don't know what it's like to have a. You understand what I'm saying?
Get your ass out there. Get your robe so you ain't cold. The fuck?
Anyways, y'all.
I gotta figure out this bed situation.
What bed situation?
Bad.
Mover, the loading people, trash. Never again. Never again. First of all, I was just trying to keep them from being in the way.
She's a baby.
Hi, mommy. Oh, you ain't got no pants on. Where's your pants? Where's your pants?
Hello.
Hi, mommy.
Hi, Gigi. What?
Me and Gianna are in prison.
You're not in prison, Tootie.
Yay, Boogie!
Yay, Boogie. Gianna turned 2, you guys, while we've been gone. She turned 2 on the 22nd. Donuts. Donuts. Say good morning, guys. You gotta eat that one first, okay? Say good morning.
Morning.
You want
morning.
Another? You want another one, Gigi?
Morning.
Morning. Hi, girl.
Hi.
Hi, girl. Say hi, YouTube.
Hi, everyone. Welcome to Avery's channel. So today we've been going to our new house. So we've been putting all the stuff in the house.
I'll go get your slippers.
And we got fire. So we just went to our new house and it's here. That's my daddy. Daddy.
Oh, what's up, man? Gang.
And these are my sister. This is Kelly. That's Gianna. Say hi.
Hi.
Say hi to our videos. So today my mom ordered me donuts because I love donuts. I've been waiting so long to eat the whole thing. And now I have.
Oh, they're a little tight, okay?
And I also got Christmas sprinkles. Whatever. Okay? And these are my pictures. That's my dad, that's my mom, that's my sister. That's me, that's my sister, that's my sister. I have 2 siblings and 1 older sister. That's my mommy.
I'll change your pants, okay? So, we just ordered breakfast tacos.
My diaper quit.
Why do you have on a diaper? Why don't you have on your undies? So, Gianna is the only kid of ours that eats normal food. The rest of them will only eat pizza, french fries, mac and cheese. Say breakfast taco.
Donut
breakfast. We order coffee and breakfast for the movers too.
No.
It's yummy.
Donuts for
Jay. That's yummy taco. She eats everything that I eat. She's tried everything. She's not afraid to try something new. She eats greens, southern food. Ugh. She eats southern food. She eats Jamaican food. Mexican food.
Ooh. Look at this.
Mm-hmm. It's cheesy. Mm-hmm. Avery, you're making a mess. You're getting sprinkles all over the trash can. Let me help Boogie.
Jay don't want a donut.
No.
Jay don't. Yeah, she does. She's just sweet.
Yeah, that's why I saved the four donuts for Jay.
Yeah, let Jay wake up on her own.
Stay supply, us, me, extra chargers.
I'll find a box.
Okay, Mom.
Hmm?
Bye,
I love you, too.
Oh, in fact.
I love you, too.
Yes, we will. Hey, Mom. No, it's okay.
It's okay. Bite it. Don't be sad. Bless you, Avery.
What are you doing, honey?
Yeah, I'm helping you. Here.
Mommy,
hold your taco. You're welcome. Bite it.
Did I say donuts?
She's eating brisket and I'm eating chorizo. But she likes this one too. Mm-hmm. Who's that? Thank you. Okay, I'm getting wipes to wash your hands. Okay, Gigi? I'm getting wipes. Yeah, so last night we had an air mattress. We had an air mattress. I think there's like a little hole in it because it was like slowly just seeping back out. So we just crashed on the floor. When I tell you I had to like stack pillows and lay on top of the big like decorative pillows, my back was toe up this morning. Look at this. Oh my God. The new phones show everything, child. Oh, I'll take it. The weather.
Huh?
Four. Is it four?
No, it's real three.
It's three.
Three.
Does three have three. A bed?
Four.
Yes.
Four.
That's four? Okay. I'm heading over to the other house to go grab some last minute stuff that we could not fit on the truck. They did a good job, y'all. The movers yesterday were so trash. Like, I'm gonna post a picture of what the truck looked like after they had loaded it up. But the movers that came and unloaded super fast, they fucked nothing up. Great. But we gotta go to the other house to go grab the other stuff that we need. And then we'll be done. And I can like officially start unpacking. I need some shoes. Jay, you ready? Jay's finally awake. Oh, you got a dress. Look at that hair though. Grab some donuts. If you want to grab the whole thing, you don't, it's just sprinkles on it. You don't want that?
Can I try one?
Try it. If you don't like it, then don't eat it. Avery picked the sprinkles off. She didn't like the sprinkles either. Not you smelling it. It's just chocolate. If you don't want it, don't eat it. But don't get sprinkles on the floor now. Get in the box. Eat it. Take a bite of it in the box. I'll be in the car. Wherever you are, babe. Outdoor spot. Yeah, so hopefully this don't take long. Get in, Avery. Sit down. Sit. You can get in the front row. Yeah, that movers did a good job. I'm so ready to be just done. This is gonna be the one and only last trip we go back over there. Cause I'm really ready to sit down somewhere. All right, daddy's coming.
Do I get to sleep in my bed tonight?
Yep, everybody's gonna be in their bed tonight.
Hey, did y'all see my keys upstairs at all?
Yeah,
Callie,
I saw someone.
Don't worry about it, babe.
I'll just go around you. I put it by the window.
Can you go get it?
Sure. I know how to back in and come back over here when we get back.
I'll be right back.
Gonna let me move out the way and then you're gonna pull the car in?
No, I'm just gonna back it up.
Oh, okay. We're not loading anything in the truck, right?
No.
Okay. I'm hot. And gasless. I got 42 miles to E.
the house is those little areas that you could put the plant in. The plant just gave me vibes of like a really, really, really tall house.
Yeah, I have a 7-foot tree plant to put in there in like the corner somewhere. Thank you, sir. Sit back. All right, let's go. Look at you doing the Lord's work. Can you reach? Sweep what? We don't got that. We didn't leave nothing. You gonna get charged. Why don't you let Daddy do that? Cause it's gonna come unfolded if you can't get it up there. Okay. Okay, guys, we got boba. Yay! Everybody got milk tea. Except for Mom, I tried something new.
Boba.
I got.
Boba, cherry punch.
Hold on, I don't know what that is. Mine looks different than everybody else. Oh, I got some kind of like chocolate coffee, like coffee. Something.
Oh, Dad got boba too.
Their boba looks a little different.
No, Dad didn't get boba.
See? It looks different. It's just squares, okay? This is what the girls got. They got milk tea.
Wow!
Hold on. Okay, the girls got milk tea.
See in there.
What? I'm showing.
Yeah, but you're blocking the straws.
Oh. Here.
For me.
And then this is mine. I hope it's good. Go upstairs. Said I'm all clean. Your room's not ready. Upstairs. Go play in the playroom.
Come on.
Go, Gigi. Turn on the playroom light, Jade. Are y'all in the other room?
Yeah.
All right, then that's fine. Just stay in the media room. Go, Gigi, Mama. I'll go get your toys. How about we were coming from Target because we have a partnership for like a Christmas type of deal.
So, we got this partnership. We were going to go grab some stuff that we needed from Target. Leaving Target, right? Why did I hit somebody? Like, we're literally turning out of the Target parking lot. Two cars put their blinker on to turn in. There was no other cars. So, the car in front of me started to pull out because they saw they were turning and then decided to just stop. So, of course, I popped them in the back and me and my husband get out the car. There's no damage to the car, y'all. Nothing to theirs, nothing to ours. But they're Mexican. They don't speak any English, so they say. So we were having to translate with them through like the English to Spanish, Spanish to English little app on Google. I was so frustrated because he immediately got out like holding his neck. Touched his neck one time, never touched his neck again. And then the wife was doing this whole grabbing her neck thing. And okay, it's like, okay, if something's wrong with you, that's fine. My husband's like, if you need to go to the doctor, let us know. Do you need to call somebody? Do you need to call police? So he's just like, no, we need to, he was trying to translate and think, we need to call the police. My wife is hurt, she need to go to the doctor. I'm not gonna say they was faking or they were lying, but it was not giving, I'm injured. So this whole time we're waiting, sitting still with our hazards on, where you turn out, and I'm thinking that he's called the police already and they're on the way. This man has not called the police. So I'm just sitting, I'm frustrated because I'm having to translate through this app and I'm just like, hurry up, like I can't communicate with you. It's pissing me off because I'm like, what are we doing here? If there's an accident and I have my insurance, my ID and all that, I can give you that info and then you go file your claim. So I'm trying to tell him that through the app, you file your claim through USAA. They'll do all the process and blah, blah, blah. He was like, oh no, I need to wait for the police. My wife needs to see a doctor. But did not call. So I'm like, do you want us to call the police? Like, do you want us to call? My husband's like, we can call the police. Like, what are you wanting to do? And I'm trying to tell this man, we're in the middle of the road. You need to pull into the parking lot. But we can't understand. He can't understand me. So it seems. So I finally put in the translator, like, and I'm just at this point almost yelling, like, go to the parking lot. We will follow you to the parking lot. So we get to the parking lot. His job happens to be right there, y'all. So he went in there and I'm like, on the text app, did you call police? Like, we need to get this process going so we can be on our way. We still got shit to do. He has not called anybody, y'all. He texts his coworker. Apparently his job was right there. In the parking lot. So his coworker comes outside. His coworker's like talking to him in Spanish and just kind of, and the coworker's black and then another one was white. They come out like talking, hearing what he's saying. He decided to grab his neck again after like 20 minutes. The wife is sitting in the car all still. And then what's funny is my husband went over to the car to go ask her if everything was okay. And then as soon as he walked up to the car, she hurried up and went like this and grabbed her neck. So I was over it. I'm like, there's no injury to your car. Like, nothing, y'all. Not a dent, not a scratch, not a nothing. I literally just tapped them. And then I immediately put my truck in reverse and got out to go look. I took pictures of, like, their plates and my car, their car, all that good stuff. And so now she's sitting in the car just stiff. Not holding her neck, but not moving, not talking, not saying nothing. She didn't get out of the car at all. Once we got to the parking lot. So the coworkers came out and the black guy is just kind of translating for us, basically talking. And the black guy was immediately, this is his coworker, you guys, like his manager. He was just like, it's giving scam. Like they trying to see what they can get out of this situation. He was just like, because any logical person, when you get in an accident, would have immediately, like if you're hurt, they would immediately call for the police to come, do a police report, get the insurance. He didn't ask for my insurance. He didn't ask for my ID. He asked for nothing. I'm trying to offer this stuff to him so we can be on our way. But when my husband mentioned like lawyer, he was like, no, 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 no. So I'm really irritated at this point because I'm like, I'm ready to move on. There's no damage to our vehicles, no nothing. I'm not hurt. Nobody in my car's hurt. Apparently their necks hurt. They both were holding their neck in the same place. So my husband mentioned like lawyer, police, doctor, whatever, like whatever you want. It's fine. It's cool. I hit you. That it's cool. I was driving. They didn't want to do none of that. So he sent on the little text app saying, oh, she just needs to be careful. And I'm like, sir, really? You're the one that started pulling out and decided to slam on your brakes and change your mind. Like, I'm thinking we going. Regardless, I hit the back of him, so I take responsibility for it. It's cool. It's whatever. What do you want to do? Child, all of that to say they ended up driving off with nothing. Nothing. That pissed me off so bad because I truly feel like they was faking, saying they neck hurt, trying to see if I was just going to offer them money. I feel like that's what they were looking for me to do, like just offer them $500-$600, like right then and there. No, I'm not doing that. You want this insurance, you want this ID, you want this policy number, you call the police. Call them. But there's that. So my whole evening, I got my little boba. This happened right after the boba, y'all. I hated the boba. Got home, finally, got something to eat, got home. And now we're trying to just unpack. And I'm so tired. My knees are aching. Just hella tired. But anyways, y'all, happy Vlogmas. I guess I'll call it that. And I'll see y'all tomorrow.